put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. The profession is overcrowded, and the struggle is pretty tough. And admitting the fact she's burning to act, that isn't quite enough. She has nice hands to give the wretched girl her due, but don't you think her bust is too developed for her age? I repeat, Mrs. Worthington, sweet Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage. Regarding yours, dear Mrs. Worthington, of Wednesday the 23rd, although your baby may be keen on a stage career, how can I make it clear this is not a good idea for her to hope, dear Mrs. Worthington, is on the face of it absurd. Her personality is not in reality exciting enough, inviting enough for this particular sphere. Don't put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage. She's a bit of an ugly duckling, you must honestly confess, and the width of her seat would surely defeat her chances of success. It's a loud voice, and though it's not exactly flat, she'll need a little more than that to earn a living wage. On my knees, Mrs. Worthington, please, Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage. Don't put your daughter on the stage, Mrs. Worthington, don't put your daughter on the stage. Though they said at the School of Acting she was lovely as Peer Gynt, I'm afraid on the whole an ingenue role would emphasize her squint. She's a big girl, and though her teeth are fairly good, she's not the type I ever would be eager to engage. No more buts, Mrs. Worthington. Nuts, Mrs. Worthington. Don't put your daughter on the stage.
Mad about the boy. I know it's stupid to be mad about the boy. I'm so ashamed of it, but must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy. Walking down the street, his eyes look out at me from people that I meet. I can't believe it's true, but when I'm blue in some strange way, I'm glad about the boy. Lord knows I'm not a fool girl. I really shouldn't care. Lord, not a schoolgirl in the flurry of her first affair. Will it ever cloy this odd diversity of misery and joy? I'm feeling quite insane and young again, and all because I'm mad about the boy. My rental, and I can't afford to waste much time. If I could employ a little magic that would finally destroy this dream that pains me and enchains me, but I can't because I'm mad about the boy, mad about the boy. I'm mad about the boy.
Country blues are getting me down. Oh, escape those dreary 20th century blues. Why, if there's a God in the sky, why shouldn't he grin up high above this dreary 20th century din? In a strange illusion, chaos and confusion, people seem to lose their way. What is there to strive for, love or keep alive for? Say, hey, hey, call it a day. Blues, nothing to win or to lose. It's getting me down. Blues, escape those dreary 20th century blues. Thank you.
whenever spring breaks through again, time may lie heavy between, but what has been is past forgetting. This sweet memory across the years will come to me, though my world may go awry, in my heart will ever lie just the echo of a sigh. Goodbye. Time may lie heavy between, but what has been is past forgetting. Though my world may go
London pride has been handed down to us. London pride is a flower that's free. London pride means our own dear town to us, and our pride it forever will be. Whoa, Liza, see the Costa barrows, the vegetable marrows, and the fruit piled high. Oh, Liza, little London sparrows, Covent Garden Market where the Costas cry. Cockney feet mark the beat of history, every street pins a memory down. Nothing ever can quite replace the grace of London town. There's a little city flower every spring unfailing, growing in the crevices by some London railing. Though it has a Latin name, in town and countryside, we in England call it London Pride. London Pride has been handed down to us. London Pride is a flower that's free. London Pride means our own dear town to us, and our pride it forever will be. Hey, lady, when the day is dawning, see the policeman yawning on his lonely beat. Gay lady, Mayfair in the morning, hear your footsteps echo in the empty street. Early rain and the pavement's glistening, all Park Lane in a shimmering gown. Nothing ever could break or harm the charm of London town. In our city darkened now, street and square and crescent, we can feel our living past in our shadowed present. Ghosts beside our starlit Thames, who lived and loved and died, keep throughout the ages London pride. London pride has been handed down to us. London pride is a flower that's free. London pride means our own dear town to us,
and our pride it forever will be. Gray city, stubbornly implanted, taken so for granted for a thousand years. Say city, smokily enchanted, cradle of our memories, our hopes and fears. Every blitz your resistance toughening, from the writ to the anchor and crown, nothing ever could override the pride of London town.
Enchanted meeting, life changed its tune, the stars and moon came near to me. Dreams that I dreamed like magic seemed to be clear to me, dear to me. You were there. Your eyes looked into mine and faltered everywhere. The color of the whole world altered, false became true. My universe tumbled into, the earth became heaven for you. Were
I'll keep all my dreams apart till one comes true. No matter what price is paid, what stars may fade above,
figure out why the world is round. We'll be as happy and contented as birds upon a tree, high above the mountains and sea. Sorrow will never come, oh, will it ever come to our room with a view? Bill and you're cool. and sorrow will never come. Oh, will it ever come to our room with a view?
The lady was beautiful, the lady was dark. She wasn't too dutiful, but still left her mark on volumes of history and thousands of checks. And all through the mystery of old double sex, Josephine, Josephine, from the first was rather chic. As a tot, she would trot through the island of Martinique. Her fortune was told by an aged crone who prophesied fame and romance, and who hissed in her ear the outrageous idea that she'd also be Empress of France. Josephine, Josephine, had with men a set routine, and the people who thought her technique was self-taught didn't know Josephine. Whatever she nearly did from 5 to 15, we know that she really did begin the begin. On first meeting Bonaparte, she murmured hell's bells. You let down the tone apart from everything else. Josephine, Josephine, very seldom lost control, though her wit was a bit over-seasoned with sauce Creole. She very soon married this short young man who talked about soldiers all day, but who wasn't above making passionate love in a coarse, rather Corsican way. Josephine wasn't keen, and she made an ugly scene. Then Napoleon cried, "Pooh, you are just talking through your chapeau, Josephine, Josephine, Josephine." Though a queen remained at home, while her lord was abroad, sending postcards in code from Rome. He often appeared with a three-day beard from Austria, Poland, or Spain. And one dreadful night, he arrived rather tight, having mucked up the Russian campaign. Josephine, turning green, cried, "What ever does this mean?" Then Napoleon cried, "Whoops, I have lost all my troops in the snow. Josie, oh Josie, go Josephine."
Thank you. are in the limbo of the swiftly passing years. Lie all our hopes and dreams and fears. Where have they gone? Words that rang so true. When love in our hearts was new. Where in the shadows that we have to pass among lie those songs that once we sung?
Is free again, belongs to me again. The brief illusion I live for has gone. No more confusion and tears from now on. To start again and break my heart again. If you should ask me to, I'd say, to hell with you. No, never again. Never the strange, unthinking joy. Never the pain. Let me be wise. Let me learn to doubt romance. Try to live without romance. Let me be sane. Time changes the tune, changes the pale unwinking stars, even the moon. Let me be soon strong enough to flout romance and you're out, romance, never again. Time changes the tune, changes the pale unwinking star, even. Let me be strong enough to flout romance and say you're out, romance, never again.
Duchess had manner for dignity lurks in the shadows of Debrett, but fate threw a spanner smack into the works, tarnishing her coronet. Three large sons were born to her,
But one sad morn to her there came a premonition of regret. Said the Duchess, well, something doesn't gel. Said the Duchess, well, hell. Imagine the Duchess's feelings on having hatched out her brood, to find her first son was weak though well-mannered, her second rather stupid, and her third plain rude. Her eldest son when in trouble went white, her second son looked blue and hung his head. But imagine the Duchess's feelings when her youngest son went red. She sent them to Eton, traditional youth was theirs whatever else they got. But nothing could sweeten the bitterest truth that baby wasn't quite so hot. High life gave no joy to him, the hoi polloi to him provided something that his peers did not. Said her grace aghast, is it going to last? Said her grace aghast, blast. Imagine the Duchess's feelings, you could have pierced her with swords when she discovered her youngest liked Lenin and sold the daily worker near the House of Lords. Her eldest son went to Boodles and White's, her second joined the Blues his father led. But imagine the Duchess's feelings when her youngest son went red. Imagine the Duchess's feelings, her overwhelming despair, to find her third son hobnobbed with the butler and sang the International in Belgrave Square. Her first son's debts bled the family white, her second son blued everything and fled. But imagine the Duchess's feelings when the apple of her eye went red. Poor Mammy, her youngest son went red.
Dance, little lady, youth is fleeting to the rhythm beating in your mind. Dance, 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 little lady, so obsessed with second best, no rest you'll ever find. Time and tide and trouble never, never wait. Let the cauldron bubble, justify your fate. Dance, 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 little lady. Dance, 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 little lady. Leave your troubles behind. Never, never wait. Let the cauldron bubble, justify your fate. Dance, 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 little lady. Dance, 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 little lady. Leave your troubles behind.
Sometimes I'm east, sometimes I'm west. No chains can ever bind me. No remembered love can ever find me. I travel alone. There are the places and faces alone. When the dream is ended and passion has flown, I travel alone. Free from love's illusions, my heart is my own. I travel alone. The world is wide, and when my day's done, I shall at least have traveled free. Led by this wanderlust that turns my eye to far horizons. For time and tide won't wait for anyone. There's one illusion left for me, and that's the happiness I've known.
Thank you.
most of every day, most of every hour of every day, I'm thinking of you, lovely one, when you turned away, when you smiled that smile and turned away, I knew we were through, lovely one. Still my foolish heart insists on aching, no release, asleep or waking. Most of every day, most of every hour of every day, I'm thinking of you. Time makes a mess of things, oh, what a mess of things time makes. Time breaks a lot of things, oh, what a lot of things time breaks. Now I'm apart from you, remembering joys that we both of us knew. Time keeps on beating, repeating, repeating, my heart aches. Most of every day, most of every hour of every day, I'm thinking of you, lovely one, when you turned away, when you smiled that smile and turned away, I knew we were through, lovely one. Still my foolish heart insists on aching, no release, asleep or waking. Most of every day, most of every hour of every day, I'm thinking of you.
In tropical climes, there are certain times of day when all the citizens retire to tear their clothes off and perspire. It's one of those rules that the greatest fools obey, because the sun is much too sultry and one must avoid its outward violet ray.
Papa-laka, 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 boo.
Papa-laka, 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 boo.
Digga-rigga,
digga-rigga, digga-rigga-doo. Yes, the natives grieve when the English leave their huts, because they're obviously definitely nuts. Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The Japanese don't care to, the Chinese wouldn't dare to. The Hindus and Argentines sleep firmly from 12 to 1. But Englishmen detest our siesta. In the Philippines, there are lovely screens to protect you from the glare. In the Malay states, they have hats like plates which the Britishers won't wear. At 12 noon, the natives swoon and no further work is done. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. I say, Crothers, will shall you ever forget that India hunt? We were hunting tigers, you see, and... Oh, so sorry.
That's quite all right.
Thank you. It's such a surprise for the Eastern eyes to see that though the English are effete, they're quite impervious to heat. When the white man rides, every native hides in glee, because the simple creatures hope he will impale a solar topi on a tree.
Bolly, 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 ba.
Very, 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 ba.
Hubbinini, 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 ha.
Hubbinini, 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 I say that's a frightfully good one, isn't it? Mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday sun. The smallest Malay rabbit deplores this stupid habit. In Rangoon, the heat of noon is just what the natives shun. They put their scotch or rye down and a lie down. In a jungle town where the sun beats down, there is peace from 12 to 2. Even caribous lie around and snooze, for there's nothing else to do. In Bangkok, at 12 o'clock, they foam at the mouth and run. But mad dogs and Englishmen go out in the midday, out in the midday, out in the midday sun. Ow! What? Oh,
I sighed.